Welcome to CubeByte series. Today we will solve three problems based on fiber optics. First question. An optic fiber has a core refractive index N1 and cladding refractive index N2. Then the numerical aperture NA is. This numerical aperture NA, it is the ability of a fiber to collect the light. This numerical aperture gives the idea how much light a fiber can collect. And that equation 4 is that it is N naught sin theta A. This theta A is the acceptance angle. When light falls on the core, when we launch the light into the core, there has to be some angle. If it is above, it won't get propagated. So that maximum value of that angle is the theta A. So N naught sin theta A equals square root of N1 square minus N2 square. This is the numerical aperture equation NA. So the answer is option A is the right answer. See, if you see here, it is relating the this numerical aperture where N1 and N2 are the refractive indices. So let's move to the next question. Major advantage of fiber optic communication compared to line communication is, what are the advantages? The answer is option A, more bandwidth. What are the other advantages? Low alternation. Once we transmit information through this optical cable, almost per kilometer, 1 kilometer, we are going to have a loss of 0.2 dB. So it is somewhat okay. It is not too much loss. And what is the other thing? It has got no EMI. Electromagnetic interference is not there with the optical cable. Also, it's a low cost. Information. Next one is the information carrying capacity is more. So these are the basic advantages. Now, let's quickly see how the optical cable. See here, it is like a two concentric rings. So this is the cladding and this is the core. The center part is the core and the outer one is the cladding. And always remember, core is, let us take it as N1. That is refractive index of core. That should be always higher than the cladding. This is N2. Now, just we'll see how it works. The axis of the, we have to launch the light into the optical fiber. So this, let it be the axis of the optical fiber. Now we will launch the light. So it has come here. This should be within the acceptance angle, and then like this inside the core, light travels. Here we will get an angle. Okay, no need to go in detail. So this the propagation of light through the optical cable is due to total internal reflection. Total internal reflection. Total internal reflection. For that, what are the conditions we need? The N1 should be greater than N2. This is the last question. Optic fiber has core of higher refractive index. Now that we know, what we know, the core refractive index, that is N1. You should remember like this, the core refractive index should be higher than the cladding refractive index. So which is the answer? Core of higher refractive index than cladding. So the answer is option A is the. These are simple questions, but don't mistake this. Core always has to be more. Core is something like a thick. We can assume like that it is something thick. Now see, this is a diagram showing the, see, through total internal reflection light is traveling. So inside the, if the light is not actually bending, it is going through an angle, the total internal reflection is happening due to that. And inner core with higher refractive index, outer cladding with low refractive index. Let's see in the next quick bite, we'll try to solve some problems from this fiber optic communication. So if you like the video, please share with your friends. Don't forget to hit the like button.